Michael Winlo is back with me this morning from Emyria. Michael, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you?
Good, thanks, Michael. You've announced here dosing complete now for the 12 participants in your RX5 phase one clinical trial. This is a big milestone for you.
A great milestone for our company running into Easter. All 12 participants, as planned, have now received Emyria's ultra pure cannabidiol capsule, which is a really great accomplishment. It means that the important analysis can now take place on how our drug is performing from a safety, tolerability, and importantly, bioavailability point of view. And we'll be comparing, as we've made public, our treatment against the sole registered cannabidiol medicine available in the world today, that's Epidiolex. And that head-to-head comparison, really important for our registration plans ahead.
And you say this has happened in a fairly short space of time. I believe it's only 8 months or thereabouts since you first started talking about dose development here.
If you follow drug development at all, you know that's an incredibly rapid velocity at which to travel from just conceptualization only 8 months ago, right through the dose form development, of which we have two great candidates that we're now taking to trials. And today to complete our phase one trial is really, really rapid progress. Clearly the team's worked hard. We've also had a few unique advantages in our favor. And that is, you know, we knew what we wanted to make. We had great real-world experience and data from patients that we've treated at our clinical services, which gave us the insights on what doses we needed to make and really how our patients needed to see that dose form. And of course, our team is really experienced in drug development. So we always, knew how we needed to make this treatment to meet the standards of the TGA and the FDA as well.
And the focus initially for RX5, Michael, on psychological distress sounds fairly broad. Just remind us what that is.
Yeah, it sounds like a fearsome condition that you wouldn't want, and that's kind of true. It is a problem that's recognized clinically and affects about 15% of adults around the world. And it's analogous to thinking of, say, someone having the cold. But in this sense, we're speaking more about their mental well-being. And so it can manifest with a range of symptoms. And it's the symptoms that are the important things that we're trying to treat. So symptoms of psychological distress can present as sleep disturbance or mild symptoms of anxiety, stress, can even create GI upset in some patients as well. And when we're unsure what's going on, we tend to bundle those symptoms together as psychological distress. And we believe that by targeting those symptoms, you know, we're going to be addressing a big unmet need. And if we can create a registered and available treatment over the counter for patients to collect without a prescription, represents a huge opportunity for us. And really just the first stepping stone, a proof of concept, if you will, of our model that we wish to apply to further registrations for this same dose form and others with the TGA and the FDA. And that's, I think, the big exciting picture here.
As far as the pivotal phase three for RX5, you've announced here a master's services agreement. Tell us a bit about it.
Yeah, we did. So we've got a really great partner in clinical trials. They're a really unique combination of both contract research organization and site management organization. What does that mean? It means they've got really deep relationships with a variety of general and specialist medical practices around Australia that we expect to work with 5 to 6 across the country, which means that we can recruit really rapidly. We can also use our own clinics that we also manage, the Emerald Clinics Network around Australia, to identify patients and refer them in as well. So we're actually really confident we're going to have a rapid recruitment success for our phase three. And today's announcement is one step closer to that phase three. So once we've got this phase one done, we can go straight into our phase three program. Now, importantly, we're skipping a phase two, and people might say, well, what's going on there? And the key thing is, from our real world patient data, which I mentioned before, we've already got some of the great insights on what dose we need, what indication we think this is going to respond to most effectively. And that allows us to skip that phase two and go straight into this phase three. Again, an acceleration of the program. That's something we really keen to demonstrate.
Good to see you, Michael. Thanks very much.
Wonderful. Thank you for your time.